Namaskar students, this is Pamela ma'am and today we will discuss Dalton's atomic theory. The postulates of Dalton's atomic theory are: elements are made up of tiny particles called atoms. All atoms of a given element are identical. The atoms of a given element are different from those of any other element. Atoms of one element can combine with atoms of other elements to form compounds. A given compound always has the same relative numbers and types of atoms. Atoms are indivisible in chemical processes. That is, atoms are not created or destroyed in chemical reactions. A chemical reaction simply changes the way the atoms are grouped together. These were the postulates given by Dalton, but there are many drawbacks in his atomic theory. He told matter is composed of indivisible particles, but later experimentally matter was divided into subatomic particles. Then second postulate, all atoms of a particular element are identical. But after the discovery of isotopes, the postulates became faulty. Isotopes are atoms of the same element but a different mass due to the different number of neutrons. So, all atoms of a particular element are identical. This postulate was incorrect. Then, third postulate, different elements have different atoms. It was correct. Fourth one, atoms combine in certain whole number ratios. And this postulate was also correct. And the law was known as law of definite proportions, which I have discussed in my previous video. In a chemical reaction, atoms are merely rearranged to form new compounds. They are not created, destroyed, or changed into atoms of any other elements. This postulate was correct except for nuclear reactions. In nuclear reactions, the atoms change. Atoms of one element change to different element. So, a modern atomic theory was put forward by the scientists. And the modern atomic theory states that atoms are not indivisible, they are made up of protons, electrons, and neutrons. Atoms of the same element can and do have different masses. These atoms are called isotopes. Isotopes have the same number of protons but a different number of neutrons. Atoms of different elements are different. They differ in their physical and chemical properties. Compounds are formed by the joining of atoms of two or more elements. They are joined in a definite whole number ratios, such as 1 is to 1, 1 is to 2, 1 is to 3, or 2 is to 3, etc. Chemical reactions involve the rearrangement of atoms to make new compounds. So these were the statements of modern atomic theory. Then Avogadro's hypothesis. Avogadro's hypothesis states that equal volume of all gases at the same temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules, such as gases like oxygen, nitrogen, methane, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, hydrogen, etc. all contain the equal number of molecules at the same temperature and pressure. this was the experiment he did in container. These are all similar container and the volume of the containers are 22.4 liter. So in one container he took helium gas and in another container he took nitrogen gas and in another container he took methane gas, and the pressure was 1 atmospheric pressure and the temperature was 0 degrees Celsius. Now we know that mass of helium is 4 gram and nitrogen is 28 gram, whereas methane is 16 gram. Now mass 4 gram of helium will occupy 22.4 liter of volume at 1 atmospheric pressure and 0 degree Celsius. And the number of molecules present will be 6.02 × 10⁻³. Similarly, nitrogen gas, 28 gram nitrogen gas occupies 22.4 liter volume at 1 atmospheric pressure and 0 degree Celsius, and the number of molecules are 6.02 × 10³. Similarly, 16 gram methane occupies of 22.4 liter of volume at 1 atmospheric pressure and 0 degree Celsius, and the molecules, number of molecules present in this volume will be 6.02 × 10³. This is the Avogadro's laws of formula. So we have seen that volume varies with n, number of molecules. So V by N will be equal to K, that is proportionality constant. So V here is volume of gas, N here is number of moles of the gas, and K is a constant. So it can be written as, also written as V1 N1 will be equal to V2 by N2. Now application of Avogadro's hypothesis. So atomicity of molecules. Okay, so in Avogadro's hypothesis he stated that equal volume of all gases will occupy will contain same number of molecules. Okay, now some gases or some elements are monoatomic or diatomic or triatomic. So monoatomic elements or monoatomic molecules are those when molecule is formed by single atom only, it is called monoatomic molecule. Generally noble gases form monoatomic molecules. For example, helium, neon, krypton, xenon, etc. These all are monoatomic gases. And diatomic molecules, when molecule is formed by the combination of two atoms it is called diatomic molecule. Say for example, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, etc. These are all diatomic molecules. Similarly, triatomic molecules, molecule is formed by the combination of three atoms. Say, example is ozone gas. Okay, so the number of molecules will be same in equal volume of gases, but the number of atoms will be varied. Now from Avogadro's hypothesis, he gave the definition of atoms and molecules. Atoms are the smallest particles of a substance which may or may not have independent existence. monoatomic elements like noble gases, platinum, silver, these exist as monoatomic elements. Molecule. Definition is the smallest unit of a substance that exhibits all the properties characteristic of that substance. Now, two or more atoms joined together to form molecule. Example, oxygen. Oxygen is a diatomic molecule. Two oxygen atoms form one oxygen molecule. Similarly, ammonia, NH3, one nitrogen atom and three hydrogen atom forms one molecule. Methane, CH4, H2SO4, SO2, these are all molecules. Now, what is atomic mass? The mass of an atom is known as atomic mass, and we know that atom is made up of proton, neutrons and electrons. So the mass of proton, neutron and electron is known as atomic mass. Relative atomic mass. An element's atomic mass relative to the mass of a carbon 12 atom. And atomic mass units or AMU or U. A unit of mass defined as 1 by 12th mass of one carbon 12 atom is known as atomic mass unit. Now, why relative atomic mass is necessary? The actual atomic mass of an individual atom of an element is so small that we use a relative atomic mass. Say, for example, hydrogen is the lightest atom and it has mass 8.275 into 10 to the power minus 25. So it is mass is so small that it is very difficult to calculate any measurement, difficult to calculate in experiments. So we take hydrogen, the mass of hydrogen as 1. Hydrogen, so we say that hydrogen has a relative atomic mass of 1. Experiments have shown that an atom of carbon weighs 12 times as much as an atom of hydrogen. So the relative atomic mass of carbon is 12. So with respect to hydrogen, relative atomic mass is determined. This is known as relative atomic mass. Now, relative atomic mass can be abbreviated to AR or RAM and is found on the periodic table. So, the masses given in periodic table are all relative atomic mass. And relative atomic mass has no units because it's a ratio. Now, the isotopes and relative atomic mass. We know that isotopes are atoms of the same elements that have different number of neutrons. Say, for example, chlorine has two isotopes. One is Cl35, where number of neutrons are 18, and one is Cl37, where number of neutrons are 20. So, relative atomic mass of chlorine can be determined taking into account of these two isotopes. Now, the abundance of Cl35 is 75% in atmosphere and abundance of Cl37 is 25%. So, the relative atomic mass of chlorine can be calculated as 75% into Cl35. So, 75% into 35 plus 25% into 37 is equal to 35.5. So, 35.5 is the relative atomic mass of chlorine. Gram atomic mass or GAM. Gram atomic mass is the atomic mass of an element in grams. Say, for example, phosphorus 15. The mass of phosphorus is 30.97, and when it is expressed in grams, it is known as gram atomic mass. Relative molecular mass, or MR, this is the total mass of a given molecule calculated by adding together the relative atomic masses of all of the atoms. Say for example H2O. Now in H2O molecule there are two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, and we know that mass of hydrogen is 1 and oxygen is 16. So the relative molecular mass of H2O will be 2 into 1 plus 1 into 16, that is 18. Similarly, relative atomic molecular mass of HCl is 36.5. Then formula mass is the sum of the atomic masses of all the atoms in a formula unit of an ionic compound. So formula mass is used for ionic compounds, and ionic compounds have no definite molecular structure. Example, ferric sulfate Fe2SO4 whole thrice. We know that iron has mass 56 or 55.845. We roughly can take it as 56, and sulfur as 32 and oxygen has 16. So after calculating, Fe2SO4 whole thrice has mass 399.879 amu. These are some examples of molecular masses of potassium hydroxide or caustic potash, which has molecular mass 56 unit. Then baking soda NaHCO3 has molecular mass 84 unit, calcium carbonate 100 units, NaOH or caustic soda, that is 40 units, C2H5OH, that is 46 unit, and NaCl or table salt has 58.5 unit. So with this we end our today's discussion. Om Namah Shivaya.